Representing the flats boat category, the Piranha Magro P180 has an overall length of 18 feet, a beam of 7 feet 6 inches, and a max horsepower rating of 150. Designed for easy poling and outstanding stability, she has a draft of 9 inches, a dead rise of 13 degrees, a dry weight of 1,050 pounds, and a fuel capacity of 27 gallons. Now, let's hear more from our hosts, George Labonte and Rick Riles.
Cap, over the years, you and I have got to do a lot of boats together. The Magro P180 is not just another flats boat. I need you to explain some of the riding characteristics. How about starting with that bow? Because that thing's unique.
This is called a plumb bow. I mean, plumb meaning it's straight up and down. And you see this design in a lot of boats. Mostly you see it in sailboats, okay? It's a design that's been around forever. You haven't seen it in a boat like this. This design right here was really built to give the boat a lot of buoyancy. So this boat takes all this hull area all the way to the stem of the boat and provides a bunch of buoyancy. This boat is not gonna go up and down and keep stuffing in a wave when you're sitting on that Oceanside flat.
I've fallen in love with wider boats and a lot of beam. It makes so much stability. I was watching you guys move around.
Yeah. Okay?
You move around on a true technical poling skiff and somebody's corner's underwater. I mean, it's just the way they are. This boat performed beautifully even with people moving in.
In addition to the benefits of having a lot more boat under you on a boat this size, having a boat this size gives you a lot more deck space to work with and a lot more room to put features on the inside of the boat. Let's move back here and have a look at a couple of them. In this big deck we've got room for not one, not two, but three live wells across the back of the boat. Now, three live wells, that's pretty significant. You know, you think about that, and one of the things that makes it hard to have those three live wells on a flats boat is you're carrying around all that extra weight. Like we were saying, more, three tanks full of water, bunch more weight. A boat this size can handle that extra weight.
Spreads it out over the beam. But you know, you're talking about the back. I want to talk about that platform a little bit. Most people, if you haven't been on a poling platform, don't ever buy a boat until you've been up on it on the water. It's a dangerous place to be.
It can be dicey standing up there, and some of them they make now, especially on those little micro boats, are like standing on a tennis racket, you know? And, you know, the guys at Piranha have got this figured out. You know, this is built for a man to pull a boat. It's not a kid's platform. They make plenty of real estate to stand on. Usually we see them with that backrest, which I like too, and it's stable. It's basically almost the full width of the back of the boat there. You can move around up there. You're not gonna step off the side of this. I love the Piranha platform.
That's my point. Having that backrest there would make all the difference in the world to me. I'd never feel like I was about to fall off, is what I'm saying.
Exactly, but you know what they've done with this deck configuration? They've added real estate. I said earlier, we want to make room for more people to fish on the boat, and you've got it. You've got that wide seat across the back. Two big guys easily sit there. You can squeeze three across the back. They're not three big guys, but three people could sit there. And then another person sits comfortably in the front. There's room to put those extra passengers, and the boat's not gonna need 3 feet of water to float in once you've done that, too.
And you also know that you can fish two in the bow and two in the stern. So you've got the room not only for four people to ride, you got the room for four people to fish. And the boat's attitude, the way it sits in the water, you're gonna be able to get shallow enough for all four of them to truly flats fish comfortably.
Okay, let's move to the front here. You've got that front seat up on the front of the console here now. Also, that's an insulated drink box or an additional, that would make four live wells. It's plumbed as a live well right now, but we've got drinks in it today. Serves two purposes. Moving up onto the deck here, big deck space up there, easily big enough deck space for two people to fish next to one another. Underneath it, there's a giant hatch in the center. Now this boat carries 27 gallons in this model right here, and the batteries you need for your trolling motor sit in there. It still leaves a ton of room inside there for storing gear.
What's her true draft when she's loaded?
They were designing this boat and they were trying to achieve a 9-inch draft on the boat. They got it. It'll float and pull in 9 inches of water.
You almost hit on this boat's reason for being. It can take three big guys into less than a foot of water and allow them to fish comfortably, but it's got the dry ride and the big water capabilities to get there. If you have to cross a choppy inlet or whatever, it does a lot of things really very, very well. If you're a shallow water fisherman, if that's your happy place, and you want to take more than one person with you when you go back there, and maybe you've got some big water to cross to get there, you need to take a look at the Piranha Magro P180.